First quarter sponsor brought to you by James Burnham State Farm. Right here. Gotta make sure you will make sure, where he'll make sure with a discount double check. Discount double check. Say that a few times fast. Discount double check. Discount double check. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you hear me? You can hear me fine, but I won't be able to hear you.
Oh,
you're just listening to what he's hearing.
What's it?
Hey, pull the cord. Hey, pull that out. Is that a mono cable or a stereo cable at the end?
It's stereo.
It is stereo?
Hey, I think it's your headset.
I used to know the name of the stadium. Testing 1, 2, 3. First quarter sponsor brought to you by James Burnham State Farm. We're going to make sure you get all your discounts with a discount double check. Luke Burnham, his son, a 16-year-old Moss Bluff team that is a junior at St. Louis High School. He runs cross country, plays soccer about 25 days ago, just a few days before school started. He was training via running and hit by an automobile and almost died. He suffered many injuries, including multiple skull fractures, broken vertebrae in his neck, and broken femur. And for more than 2 weeks, he was actually in a medically induced coma to allow the swelling in his brain to go down. This was the top head therapy center in the country, which is the top head injury therapy center in the country. His progress all being baby steps and a long process and the product of much prayer. So we do thank you for your prayerful consideration for this awesome young man and his family. And we wish you a full and speedy recovery, Luke Burnham. Keep fighting.
I was there. Okay, now it should be running. I just got it out.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So did you have to stand on your head and rub your belly and pull your toenails at the same time to get it to work? Or did you forget your password like I always do? Starting soon. In fact, what time are we starting? State Farm Insurance brought to you by Yeah, we're gonna have to bite the bullet and just he's gonna have to shut that. Yeah.
Just fall back.
Yeah. You're right. A non-district contest. Yeah. The only reason I did that is because just kept it, or tape it down, I guess. One, two, three, four, five. What you need?
I'll put down.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Whoa, not too much.
What you got?
Don't need that clear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it too hot? One, two, three, was it too hot?
I was trying to bring yours down so we can crank mine up.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five.
This.
Three, four, five, six. You.
Okay. Yeah, I do.
Okay. One, two, three. But you need to bring him up, since you're the. Why is that? I mean, this should be the master.
We're trying to get more outside.
One, two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Not getting anything, Steve?
Yeah.
For the games, I had to switch them and put it on there and then drive the gain for that mic because it's just a cheap mic.
One, two, three, four.
You want to put Richard's mic on that XLR and see if he's got a better mic?
We can, but I think we're good.
Well, you and I won't hear it, so.
Hey, it's fine. I'm more worried about what we hear. You can hear me okay?
Oh, yeah, I hear you great.
Good, okay.
I seem to not hear myself very well. Are you hearing me fine?
I'm hearing you fine.
Okay.
How's that? Any better?
Dear Luke and your family, we know a few months ago your life changed completely unexpected, but we friends here want you to know that we are praying for you, we miss you, and we support you, and that with our prayers we hope you are healed and come back to us very soon.
Luke, I pray for you every day. We all love you.
We're praying for you.
We love you.
We love you, Luke.
Luke Barnum, I need you back in my art theory class, okay? Art 2 is not the same without you. We need you back.
We miss you and love you.
Bye.
We wanted to do this for the Barnum family because we go to church with them and they're such a good Christian family and we want to do something special for them. I know they're going through some hard times right now.
All for Luke! All for Luke!
We love you!
Pray for you!
Miss you, Luke. Hope you get
doing, bro? Miss you.
You well soon, Luke.
I want to let you know that we're praying for you. We're here for you. We can't wait for you to get back here. See you later, man.
Hey, Luke. Praying for you. Hope you get better soon.
We miss you, Luke. We love you.
Love you, Luke. Can't wait to see you when you get back.
We love you, Luke.
Burn ham, scorched pork, and then you see that smile again. Bring it on.
You will soon, Luke. We miss you, buddy.
Luke, we miss you. We love you. We are hearing good news about you, and we can't wait until you come back. Bye.
We love you, Luke.
Luke, can't wait till you get back here. Every time that we have class, every time we have a soccer meeting, cross country, you are missed. We all love you.
We love you.
Sending prayers from St. Louis.
We love you.
We love you, Luke.
Get well soon.
Take care. See you soon.
We love you, Luke.
Luke, when you come back, I promise I'll be nice to you. We love you, we miss you.
Come back and join us soon. Good luck.
Love you, Luke.
Hey, Luke, we miss you. I have two classes with an empty desk right now. I'm ready for you to come back, man. God bless.
Luke, I tell you what, I've seen an outpouring of generosity on behalf of our St. Louis school community. I'm happy to represent them, but I'd like to say that you are being sent much love, much care, much healing from this St. Louis community, from the faculty, from the staff, and the students. May you know God's healing presence, may you know God's love, and may your family be blessed as you journey along the road to recovery.
Driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Burnham. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Good driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Burnham. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Good driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Burnham. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Good driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more.
In Baton Rouge.
In Baton Rouge.
He didn't listen. And it's a new crack motor on it. All everywhere.
Oh, yeah,
he flipped it up big time. He straightened the curve.
He's okay then?
He's.
Didn't your lab win the championship
right.
Too? Did they?
Nothing broken, but a whole lot of
I think so.
Up.
Who won 3A championship last year? ULAB or did?
Was it ULAB? Okay.
And this year, Curtis and Evangel moved on. They went up to 5A. The new rule lets everybody move up.
Well, they have the option.
Well, yeah, but like it used to be. The past few years, it's only been one.
Yeah.
Now they can move all the way up, so they're going to play in Division One. In the private.
Good.
School.
Good.
Yes. Good.
Good. So we're at home against Rain.
Yeah.
Next week.
Only long trip's going to be to Pineville.
Yeah.
Jennings is always fun at Jennings with that right up against the field like that. I think that's so cool.
Yeah, I was saying I have to bring it home because the matrix editing system I have in the house takes matrix.
Well, I'll
throw it all in there and
it
converts.
Yeah, it's Artigo, right?
Yes, Ken Artigo.
I may have whatever. The
yeah, I want to make sure because there's an Artigo, but I'm from the Pacific Northwest and it's pronounced Artigo.
Yeah,
Ortego,
that's right.
O-R?
O-R-T-E-G-O.
Yes, yeah, or R?
Ortego.
Or.
Ortego. Just.
Not Ortego.
No.
I just want to make sure. I still have a little Yankee in me once in a while.
No, you'll be fine.
No, I think I said Ortego. Man, it's like Michael Collins.
What's up?
James C.
What's happening?
Nothing, bro. Where y'all at? Y'all over here.
How you doing? All right. We're on this side. Good. I'm glad I got
you. You'll find me one of these days, John.
How you doing? All right.
Yeah,
doing great.
How are you doing?
Buddy, good.
Hey, boss.
Hey.
I'll probably stick that fan in the door and suck y'all some cold air that way.
Yeah. Can you help me out real quick? Who's going to be running my ball?
Okay, Cameron Fontenot will be quarterback.
And he is number?
He is number four.
Four, thank you.
And then Kobe Rodriguez, number 20, is the running
Fontenot
back.
Fontenot is a junior.
Yep.
And who? And Rodriguez?
Kobe Rodriguez will be the running back.
Uh-huh.
And then Colin Kramer will be a receiver. Washington, where's he at?
There is Tyler.
Tyler Washington, yeah.
Yeah, he's the big tall guy.
Big tall one, yeah.
Big tall one.
I don't know who else. We're going to have to see who else is going to be in the offense.
Who's my white hat today?
It's going to be hard to see.
Who they got? LHSOA got new football uniforms, is he? Made them get the Smitties. Changed up the look a little bit. I kind of like it. They had those same last year?
No, they didn't have the stripe down the pants for sure.
Okay. I knew they were going to it at one point. I just didn't know.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves homestyle breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves homestyle breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves homestyle breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Being turned down by dealerships because of your past credit? Today is your lucky day. At Bill Bailey's, your job is your credit.
With credit acceptance and your down payment, we could get you in a qualified vehicle today. Credit acceptance will help reestablish your credit, provide you with a quality used car, and put you on the road with credit recovery. So come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise Boulevard and get pre-approved today. Bill Bailey's, where we're right on the corner and right on the price. Tired of pushy salesmen and being turned down by dealerships because of your past credit? Today is your lucky day. At Bill Bailey's, your job is your credit. With credit acceptance and your down payment, we could get you in a qualified vehicle today. Credit acceptance will help reestablish your credit, provide you with a quality used car, and put you on the road with credit recovery. So come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise Boulevard and get pre-approved today. Bill Bailey's, where we're right on the corner and right on the price.
He probably won't play. Win, Shally, Corey.
Where's the big linebackers? Jamin Levi.
It's Levi.
Levi.
Okay.
Even though it looks like Levi.
It looks like Levi, but it's Levi.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the DBs will be Zachary Shore, Michael Mack, Jacob Perkle, and maybe Connor Cotrera. I'm not sure. He'll either be an outside linebacker or he'll be a DB.
Do what?
I need to get him to tell me what play they're about to run. So we say, man, I'd run the option here if I was Saint Louis. So we look like a genius. You gonna let me know?
Go ahead, boss.
Yeah, I'd definitely pass here if I was Fontenot.
You wouldn't know what it looks like when you're diabetic and you don't know it and your eyesight's going bad? It looks like looking through this window. When you're diabetic and you don't know it, my eyesight look what it looks like when you look through this window.
Yeah, was that fuzzy?
Oh. Don't ask me why. I just thought I was getting old and had to go to the eye doctor the next week or something.
Yeah, well, I need a feed into my headset from there. So that's what I need. He's got a.
He had an extra channel on that. I have a cord that
could audio out. Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Right as they're doing the coin flip. Right as they're doing the coin flip. Are we set up? Are you good? So don't say anything bad. Not that I ever do. Ken, you ready? Let's go ahead and get you ready, guys? Steve, you guys ready? All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Welcome to Sam Houston High School here in Moss Bluff for the KLOC Sports TV Game of the Week, brought to you by Tyver Ford. Give us a chance to earn your business and Lake Charles Toyota, where we know you by name. Today's game sponsor is Stein Home Improvement, everything for your home and yard. I'm Richard Dow. It is a pleasure to finally get back on the air with you here for the KLOC TV broadcast. Been following the Saints for years and glad to be back in the broadcast booth. Guy also very familiar with a set of headsets. Ken Ortego, how you doing?
Good, Richard. humid night out here tonight, 84 degrees. The humidity is about 110%, overcast. They did have some rain. I noticed some wet spots down on the field, so we'll see if that'll play into tonight's game.
Well, Saints going to kick off a year coming off a 6-6 season last year that took them back into the playoffs under first-year head coach Charlie Cryer. And year two, very promising, but got to start tough. Got to start with these Sam Houston Broncos that are in 5A.
Well, and the Saints returning 8 starters on offense and 9 on defense. And had a rough start to the beginning of the year and then really came on at the end, had a run to the playoffs before losing to eventual 3A state champion, the ULAB.
Depth will be an issue today. We'll see how things go, and we'll have the opening kickoff for you next. St. Louis Catholic Saint football on KLOC-TV.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves home-style breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat.
One. Welcome back to Moss Bluff. It's the KLOC Sports TV Game of the Week, brought to you by Tarver Ford and Lake Charles Toyota and by Stein Home Improvement. Michael Mack, get ready to tee it up for the Saints to the Broncos. Wading deep is
number four,
Cardwin and Thompson. And we will get ready to get underway. Ball's at the 40. The 2015 season is underway. High quick kick and taken by Erdogan at the 4-yard line all the way to the 20. Crosses the 25. Finally brought down by a slew of Saints. And very good. I know field position will be very critical today, and the Saints keeping them behind the 30. Welcome you today. Your first quarter sponsor brought to you by James Burnham State Farm. We'll make sure you get all your discounts with a discount double check. Big old Jamin Levi helping anchor the defensive backs and a lot of speed in the backfield. Triple set back there. The quarterback is Cameron Fontenot. Sorry, wrong. Ken swatched it around. They will do back behind the field. That's Ottawa with the run. 4-yard line. Drew Ottawa, a senior, 5'8", 145 pounds, showing off some speed.
Yeah, Broncos just sealed the corner and he got outside on him.
And he'll put it down at the 45. Big run of 19 yards to start things off. And these Broncos, we discussed it on the way in, Ken, very big on that offensive line.
Yeah, they average about 275, 6'4", 6'3", 6'1".
Man in motion, ball in the right hash, a keeper, and across the 50, gone to the 30. Actually, they will catch up finally at about the 19. Michael, good pursuit by the Saints.
Yeah, Michael Mack and Alec Reddick ran him out of bounds.
Well,
but not a good start for the Saints. Two big plays right off the bat.
Quarterback is DeBost, thank you. DeBost, 6 foot, 185 pounds. He looks bigger than that.
On that last play, it looked like Mark Johnson came on a stunt and just ran right by him and let him get to the outside.
DeBost in the shotgun.
Two linebacker set for the Saints now.
Man in motion, arm out. Snap. The hand. But DeBose will get it back, but a big break for the Saints. Little back up inside the 30 to about the 26-yard line, and that's a big break.
Sam Brookhouse is on him quick, and watch. Richard, he had a spectacular year last year at defensive line.
So are the Broncos. DeBose still. Five-yard line, that'll be good for another Sam Houston first down.
Once again, just a little delay, just waited for those linemen to clear them out and just went straight ahead. Same
to go down. Boy.
Eyes and waits for bigger than he was last
year. Split a man to the left hand side. That's Taj Barber. And they will fake one way. Nope, they did hand the ball off. Sweep left hand side of the 25 and tripped up around the 20 yard line.
They're going to spot it at about the 17, Richard. That was Michael Mack, looked like came up from the safety position.
Blair Guillory with the carry for Sam Houston. And now they're deciding where to mark it on the far sidelines. And now we have a penalty. Penalty flag is down at the 27, most likely holding. Coach Charlie Cryer saying, we're going to take that one. And that will be the second penalty of the game. Holding is the indication. So I'll back up Sam Houston. And again, Sam looked very good on their first couple of plays, and they've looked good a couple times here, although give credit to the Saints. What I do like what the Saints are doing is, yes, Sam Houston's broken a handful of tackles, but it's been the pursuit after the breaking of tackles. They've able to capitalize on bringing the Broncos down.
Looks like we're going to have a timeout.
We do have a timeout on the field. We'll take one, too. 0-0 our score. It's the St. Louis Catholic Saints and the Sam Houston Broncos game here of the 2015 season on KLOC-TV. Ends down with a little lack of depth, but the Saints hold against the higher class competition today. Here's DeBose. Pump fake has a.
So yeah. Saints will keep the ball.
Unsportsmanlike on St. Louis. Seasons, but over the last six, St. Louis has the lead 4-2. So it is always an exciting and entertaining game. Back to throw to Bose, three-man drop. Now he's going to have to get chased out of the pocket, gets a block, and just throws it where nobody's at. And there comes
the flag.
Ottawa was downfield at the 42-yard line. But DeBose did not get past the line of scrimmage. He did get outside the box.
Outside the box, but you got to throw it past the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, did not throw it past the line of scrimmage. Thank you. That will be another penalty. Do you back him up or fourth down, or you just take the punt? That's the question to Charlie Cryer. I think they're going to back him up a little bit and see if it can't get some field position. How well do you trust your defense is a big question, and Charlie says back him up. The bus. Just, I tell you what, you know, getting improved. I saw improvement every week, made it to the playoffs, and you turnover for Sam.
3 or 4.
With a discount, double check. 46 seconds. Here is Fontenot. Rodriguez and company B. Rodriguez gets the call over
touchdown.
The tackle and into the end zone. Touchdown! St. Louis Catholic has struck first blood.
They just ran it right up the gut, Richard. Looked like he was hit at the line, and he just kept pushing and went right on into the end zone.
St. Louis on the board with just 40 seconds to play. Yard run by Rodriguez. And here comes Matt. I think he thought about pitching it to Mac, just not enough room. We'll iron this out. Here is on the ground.
With credit, come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise and get pre-approved today. Bill credit acceptance, Enterprise Boulevard, on the price.
Tire
issues, including the famous in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome to Big Daddy.
Air transported to TIRR in Houston, Texas, which is the top head injury therapy center in the country. His progress all being baby steps right now, and what will be a very long process and a product of very needed prayers. So we do thank you for your prayerful consideration. Keep praying and keep it up for this awesome young man and his family. We wish you a full and speedy recovery. Luke Burnham, keep fighting, buddy. We do have the ball teed up still at the 40. I'm not quite sure where we are as far as penalty being issued. The young man appears to be... He's coming off. We thought originally it might be... They do have, by penalties, the... fumble into the end zone the last time.
Well, we had the interception by Michael Mack down here.
Yep.
The half. In the quarter.
What started off quickly because the ball control has slowed down a little bit with a couple of passes and penalties and, of course, the injury. Here's the handoff. Uh-oh.
He's got room.
Thompson found a space and it crosses the 35, 40, 45, 50. At the 40. Being pursued by Mack. Can't get him, but finally brought down
by
Contrera with good pursuit, or else Thompson's gone. So another big run of about 58 yards.
I was about to say, at least 55.
Be the weights of the offensive lottery last Friday night at Dunn with the first KLOC Sports. Can't tell it. 8th in the shot. Seven-yard problem. Sam Houston.
Grishard broke.
On the other side.
Away. Got it. Line they have.
Right. Opportunities. We saw. Important for that secondary pursuit to be able to attack.
Right. Johnson came on that outside blitz. He's got a hand on him, and once he got past him, the DBs were all back in coverage, and he had room to run.
Another first down for Sam Houston. That's five on the game.
Ball right on the stripe.
Basically in St. Louis territory. Delayed draw. Thompson broke free. He broke a tackle. Cross the 40, the 30, the 20, still on his feet, and nobody will break. 50-yard touchdown, Trevante Thompson, and just like that. Just the South Borgard TV, but I'm suddenly on a different move to a Thursday. And that's the problem is there's just not enough officials
right
in Louisiana, here in the Southwest Louisiana. So that's why we see the game. Going backwards. In the half, that'll bring Mac out, who this time will attempt the PAT kick. Saints had to go for two last time. The first time they scored, the snap was bobbled. This time, Mac is true through the pipes. And the Saints is St. Louis Catholic on the landscape management scoreboard are on top. 21-14.
Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values. If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Hi, we're the Tarvers. Southwest.
Good. Discount for that. And see State Farm agent James Burke. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
115-109 with Michael Mack to kick off. Something done. But here we go after the Saints.
I could hear
that. No. Somehow, this is a double clutch by the center, and somehow St. Louis got on top of it. Timeout.
Sam Houston's going to take their final timeout.
You take a look at those stands, and I went across the way while everybody else was feeding themselves and got our rosters tonight. Those stands are at a pretty good angle. And my bride goes running up and down those stands every day, and I just kind of like congratulate her. Yeah, good job, baby. Good. You know what? I have a lot more appreciation for what my wife goes through running up there because those things are steep. And but it's they built more area. It does not look as full as it would typically on this what used to be the home side over here. But the press box looks nice, and now we have. You know, two press boxes, which Sam Houston desperately needed when they moved up to the 5A level.
Absolutely, yeah. Like I said, it was crowded in this press box 2 years ago.
Unfortunately, some station in the stands was like, oh, well.
After all the rain today.
There's DeBost. Rolls to his right to throw. Looks and fires it downfield for LaFleur, who makes the catch at the 15. LaFleur makes the catch. They'll put him down at the 14-yard line. 15 seconds on the clock.
Had Perkle on the coverage. He just had a step on him.
DeBost will probably spike it this time. With 15 seconds, may or may not. You have to be ready for him not to. Under center. The whistle blows. Nope. Yeah, finally.
Spike it.
Spike it with 12 seconds left to play. I tell you what, Ken, this has been a fantastic start. Basically, it looked like we were going to have a scoreless first quarter. Saints took the 6-0 lead with 40 seconds left in the quarter. There were some chances for Sam. Saints defense bent but did not break. Took advantage of some turnovers and some penalties by Sam. Then scored themselves on a touchdown run by Rodriguez. That was followed up by a 10-yard touchdown by Trevante Thompson. That was on fourth down and three,
fourth and three,
and he scores from the 10. Right after that, the kickoff return by Salier for 80 yards. Another 50-yard touchdown run. The next possession by Sam with 7:24 to play, and then with 1:09 to play, Saints did a good job of taking care of the clock. They took over the ball with about 4:49 to play. And finally scored with 1:09, and we had kind of feared that they'd give Sam too much time.
And that's exactly what's
happening.
Well, the big pass play,
that huge for the Saints. Anything kept in bounds, and right now with the ball inside, they can get a first down. They can get a first down inside the five. Man in motion. Now this is the boast in the shotgun. Looks. Throws left side, touchdown. Touchdown catch by Ottawa on the left side. Everybody else is going right. He basically
wrote
a post pattern to the left-hand side, or the flat pattern, and catches it with 7 seconds to play.
He lined up right, rolled right, and he just threw it all the way across the field.
So a 14-yard touchdown pass. And we will have a halftime, and then basically both teams should be even unless Salier can run some magic again, as that PAT is also good. 7 seconds to play. 21-21 is your score on the Landscape Management Scoreboard. For Landscape Irrigation Lawn Service, call Landscape Management today. We also like to thank our game day sponsor, Stein Home Improvement. Everything for your home and yard. And all season long, our corporate sponsor, Tarver Ford, Lake Charles Toyota. Tarver Ford, give us your chance to earn your business today. And Lake Charles Toyota, where we know you by name. Big thanks and a big shout out to Philip Tarver. Even when I was broadcasting just radio-wise before I teamed up with the Eccles, Philip, very huge supporter of St. Louis Catholic Saint Athletics and what goes on at the university there. I just want to thank Philip for his sponsorship again this year.
Yeah, the Tarvers have been great to KLOC and St. Louis.
So at the 40-yard line, Cormier, who just hit the PAT, will tee it back up, try to keep it, I would guess, out of Salyer's hands. Although Perkle has some ability as well to make something happen. Perkle and Salyer, we have seen nothing but high pooch kicks out of Cormier. The side, he'll dribble her across. Somebody for St. Louis had better jump on it. Can't believe only 2 seconds came off the clock. But the Saints will get it back, most likely take a knee. Probably a tight formation here. And coaches, I know, were a little frustrated to our right. But nonetheless, a great effort defensively by the Saints, who really were on the field quite a bit defensively.
Yeah, they were. Other than a couple big plays, you're correct, Richard. We've done a good job.
Tight formation. And your first half is over. The Landscape Management scoreboard shows your St. Louis Catholic Saints and the Sam Houston Broncos tied 21-20. And we'll get ready and pass on some other scores we heard from around the area as well. Again, 21-21 your score. You're watching the KLOC Sports TV Game of the Week.
I was to the side, a little bit to the side.
When it turns orange, is it still streaming or is it
stopped? Yeah, it's just pieces together by voice.
Yeah, because that's what it just it stopped and you play a little while, then it stopped and you play a little while.
Wirecast and YouTube got it though, but when you go back and watch the replay, it'll puts it all back together. Yeah, this master music.
You don't need the audio.
Yeah. That would play.
Yeah, the same music that's coming out to play. It's just weird with new stands being on the other side. I mean, they've always been over here. The band's always been in the end zone.
Well, they didn't think about it too well. They should have, they really just wanted to play for the heat. But now it's kind of inconvenient for the,
not really.
If they would have the street rims, then
they only had one side of the gate open, and the people there apparently having a hard time. I know. When I looked at one, it was way over here.
It was past,
they used to let everybody in down here, too.
Yeah.
So I don't know if they had that game down there closed. Or...
That's aggravating for people that won't come back. You can't.
TV still. I was like, what? Nobody has a tube TV. What is this, the 1940s? What is this?
What is this, the 1940s?
Hey, but the good news is it's not homecoming, so it could have been a long first half, and then we could have had a...
An extra 20 minutes
of halftime.
The sun.
I'm just
the size of that thing.
Daughter's honey's helping them out down there somewhere.
I guess your wife's glad to see you better, huh?
I guess.
I just pissed her off.
So.
Either that or, oh, you helped me out. See you later.
Just when I thought I could trade you in for a new mom.
Yeah. Probably pissed her off and came back. Oh, shit.
I got all that insurance on him.
Yeah. You know what? I can't get a decent health. I can't get a decent life insurance right now.
I wonder why.
Making me mad.
You didn't have any before?
Huh?
You didn't have some before?
I'm on State Farm, but I'm uninsurable now.
Yeah, but I'm saying they can't take it away from you if you didn't have life insurance before.
Term. No, I mean, I have enough to get married.
I barely got enough to pay the house off and get married.
Be better off than my wife. It was first, this just got worn out. Oh. We're done. Cause I'm working at Christine Bailey's now. Christine Bailey. I can go back. I want to take his commercial. You need to send me a copy of Burnham's commercial.
He made that commercial.
So that. Can I talk to you about Monday? Here it is. How much I was insulated before before I got sick, because nothing used to bother me. Now, like right here, I'm chilly right now.
It actually feels a lot better than it used to.
There's too many people in here. It's all I get. Now this is good. I love.
Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values. If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Hi, we're the Tarvers. Southwest Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values. If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Hi, we're the Tarvers. Southwest Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values. If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Hi, we're the Tarvers. Southwest Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values. If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Hi, we're the Tarvers. Southwest Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community.
We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values.
If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves home-style breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome.
You know, I broadcast that bar championship game since Rumble. Oh my gosh. I think they put us somewhere above the puncher train. We're forever away from that game. That was one of the hardest games I've ever done. It's when they put the radio for the goal.
Why did our windows talk out there?
Dude,
it's so cool when you get that part when your kid, you're watching kids on TV, your kids know them.
Well,
yeah, I remember him, he's at that camp I went to. Yeah,
sure. Don't know what to think about this.
Yeah, all of a sudden we fogged back up. We need to get some humidity in here, and that'll fix that.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know. I hate to say it, but can we turn it? Can we turn the AC down a little bit? We're just trying to see if the.
Hey, we get the ball.
Yes.
Are we good? What are we doing here? Yeah. Welcome back to Sam Houston. This KLOC TV game of the week, the St. Louis Catholic Saints and Sam Houston will kick in the second half on the far right hand. He's got a hole again. This time he's at the 40, at the 50, being chased down by Otto, and he won't get to him. Cuts up the middle, breaks the tackle. Oh, and he gets tripped up from behind, finally, by a Sam player at the 19-yard line, already with an 80-yard return. This time takes it just inside the 20-yard line and returns it for another 70 yards.
Richard, that young man's going to be special. He's only a freshman. What a debut for him. The first time he touches the ball in a varsity football game, he runs it 80 yards. Now he has a, 60-yard return?
At least that. Here's Fontenot under center. Here's Rodriguez. Rodriguez trying to find a hole. Did not find many last half. The first half gets wrapped up and thrown down on that right side defensive line.
It looked like he kind of slipped when he went to make that spin move. I was down at field level at halftime, and it looks a lot worse at field level than it does from up here, Richard.
That turf getting a little chopped up down here. Good enough for about a one-yard gain. St. Louis gets the opening kickoff of the second half. Trying to make some magic happen. Pitch right side. Rodriguez has some room. Sprints to the outside, across the 15, down to the 10, to the 5.
Touchdown!
St. Louis Catholic with a touchdown by Rodriguez. No penalty flags on the field. And a 12-yard touchdown scamper, his second of the night.
1 minute, 1 second drive.
Wow. We had barely any scoring in the first quarter. Rodriguez touchdown made it 6-0 St. Louis Catholic at the end of one. A seesaw second quarter that saw both teams change the lead a handful of times. Mack will try to make it a 7-point lead. Snap this time is pretty good. The kick is up. The kick is the second half in the St. Louis Catholic Saints take a 28-21 lead in the land. Has been scoreboard. We'll be back for third quarter action.
Good driver. We've got to do that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Berger. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Good driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Burnham. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
One minute, 1 second into the third quarter, and St. Louis Catholic Saints have taken 28-21 lead. They're ready to kick off here. New kicker. Mack has been doing all the kicking duties this time. A kick taken down inside to the 3-yard line by Thompson. Thompson brings it up, breaks a tackle around the 28-yard line, and finally brought down.
That was number 94, Adam Ayoub. He's a sophomore.
There we go. Ayoub getting some kicking action. We knew that was the case. So, tell you what, it was a long first half about it at the half.
Almost to 9 o'clock. The game started at 7.
to Boast in the backfield. On first down and 10. Hand off to Thompson. Thompson cuts right and runs into a slew of Saints. Six. Tackle. It's an apology. We tried to turn on the lights here, and apparently the monitor out. Sam House with the tackle. Original contact. Pickup of three on the play. Down and 7 yard line. And some of that
up and Johnston just comes and cleans him out. And boy, I'd hate to have that kid running at me. Him and Levi, that's two big, strong kids in that linebacking core.
Johnston can fill out a shirt, too. 28-21, third down play on third down and long 7. We'll give you some interesting stats here. That's Ottawa in motion to Boast. Hand off. Thompson got hit in the backfield, brought down again. Brookhouse makes the original contact. His fellow Saints come in and wrap him up, and they'll set up a fourth down situation.
You know, we haven't called Brookhouse's name a lot. He's going up against the 6'5", 275 kid, but he's starting to come alive here in the second half. Now, this is just what the Saints needed. And our Broncos trying to decide what they're going to do, and they're going to punt.
Yep, they are going to bring out the punter.
So that's going to give that defense a little rest. This problem we couldn't have in the first half is the defense was on the field a lot.
Yep.
Problem we did have, I'm sorry.
So Mack is actually only standing at about the 36-yard line. They don't look convinced that they're going to punt, do they? Here is the run out of the backfield.
Oh.
And breaks a tackle. Across to the 40, first down.
First
oh, my
down.
Goodness. Still on his feet across the 35, the 40.
He's going to
35,
score.
He's going to score a touchdown on this fourth down play from the 40-yard line, 41-yard line. And that is amazing.
We had him. They had him caught in the backfield back here.
There's a penalty flag on the play, but it may be post-possession.
What? I think number 7 was kind of celebrating before he went into the end zone, pointing up to the student section. Now, what's that rule in high school? You know, in college, that celebration before you go in the end zone, and it's no touchdown.
Right. I'm not sure. Unsportsmanlike again.
He didn't give an indication which way.
Maybe. This one. I'm out for the extra point.
Touchdown years ago.
1 yard. Really focused on returning that punt. This is a long distance. This is basically a 35-yard point after attempt. Ball is down. The kick is up. And Cormier will get a kick off of a St. Louis player on the front, and it almost kicked away from him, but able to pounce on it at about the 47.
Well, that's the center, Bercier. It hit him right in the chest and bounced right in front of him. He was able to jump on it, luckily.
I guarantee you the young man did not breathe for a second.
No, he may not be breathing yet.
Well, 28-28, 8:26 to play. Richard Dowk in Orgo in a very seesaw football game.
Good field position here.
Yes, that is the big thing here. They kept the ball out of Salier's hands. And still good field position to pitch out left side.
They're going to get it to
Salier. Salier this time, across the 50. Holding call coming up on the tailback, Rodriguez.
That's too bad.
On the 50-yard line.
It's like almost a 10-yard pickup, and it's going to go for nothing.
Salier has impressed us on his kick returning abilities. Really have not seen him run out of the backfield until now.
He's been lining up at fullback. This time they split out Rodriguez, and he's at tailback, and they got him the ball and picked up good yardage, but there was going to be a holding.
Some unofficial numbers for you. This again, tied at the tail of a couple of quarterbacks, as they will back this one up to about the 40-yard line. Yep. 8-yard penalty. Backed up to the 40. It'll be first down and 18. Rodriguez had 47 yards and a touchdown coming in. He has since scored another one from 13 yards out. So at least 60 yards on the night for Rodriguez for St. Louis. Under center, Fontenot on this first down play. Pitch. End around, back to Salier. Salier sweep right side, he's got some room! At the 45-50, the 45 brought down, finally. And he really could have broken that for more if he had been able to get away from Connor Williams. I'm sorry, not Connor Williams. Apologize.
Salier picks up the first down.
Yeah, great play.
Yeah, what did they have? Thompson from Sam Houston.
Thompson from Sam Houston, 159 and two touchdowns.
Well, you know, 100 of those yards were on two plays. Yeah. So he and Rodriguez pretty equal, minus those two big plays. You know, both times the Saints had a hand on him and couldn't bring him down.
John Woodson Hayes with the saving tackle. I think Salier's gone. First down, St. Louis. Yeah, Rodriguez not finding as much luck.
No, that play never had a chance. As soon as the ball was snapped, the nose guard was in the backfield with Fontenot. They'll mark it back about a yard, yard and a half. That'll bring up the second and a long 11.
Turnover wise in the first half, Sam with two, a interception and a costly turnover on a punt snap at the Saints were able to get inside the 5-yard line. Back is Fontenot. Didn't see what he wanted.
Oh, right jump pass.
Yep. Oh, Tim Tebow-esque jump pass to the right-hand side.
Well, Fontenot took a shot there. He comes up slow. So Crawford picked up about 7 on the pass.
After the loss, it'll be 3rd down and 6. The forward progress there. It'd be tough on Mac. Mac's going both ways.
Yeah, and toward the second half of the year last year, he went both ways a lot, too. I mean, the kid's such a good athlete, got such great hands. I mean, as a free safety and a wide receiver, how can you take him off the field?
A touchdown and a handful of play-saving tackles tonight.
Timeout Saints. They didn't like what they had called.
A 3rd down call. The Saints take a timeout with 6:10 to go. My guess is this might also be the water break. Let's go ahead and take it to Landscape Management Scoreboard, 28-28. St. Louis Catholic, Sam Houston.
Big Daddy's, have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves home-style breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Salesman and being turned down by dealerships because of your past credit? Today is your lucky day. At Bill Bailey's, your job is your credit. With credit acceptance and your down payment, we could get you in a qualified vehicle today. Credit acceptance will help reestablish your credit, provide you with a quality used car, and put you on the road with credit recovery. So come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise Boulevard and get pre-approved today.
Here we go.
on the third down play after the timeout, a snap exchange, and St. Louis gives up the ball the second time tonight. Now they're going to take Dowkin or Stephen Eccles in there. The game will be done. Excited about the LSU Magnese game. And you were kind of taking a look at some high school scores. Not a whole lot of real big.
Yeah, South Cameron up 35-7, I think it was, over North Central.
Of course, the Saints will play Barb here in a couple, 3-4 weeks, and Barb is struggling up in Shreveport against Bird. Interestingly enough, a team that they did well when they were fighting for an opportunity to make it to the state championship game a handful of years back. 6:07 on the clock. There's your water break. They did not go as long because we just had a timeout. Handoff left side. Looked like it might be Hayes that got the handoff. On the left-hand side, maybe a couple. That's all the Saints are going to give up. It'll be second down and 8.
I think that was number 21.
21?
Blair Gilry. He's Gilry. A senior running
okay.
back.
Okay, my bad. 27 and 21, those numbers for Sam. They changed up their helmet scheme about 3-4 years ago. Brand, a lot of things have changed probably, Ken, since the last time you were here. With the field house going on and can't get brought down. Brookhouse full speed ahead and Perkle able to make the play deep downfield and I don't know officially, but closing in on 200 yards.
Yeah, exactly 160 before that, and that was about a 30-yard run. Yeah, you mentioned Barb. Score from Shreveport is Bird 39, Barb 7 at halftime.
All right. Wow. A little bit of a surprise is that lobster. 28-28 our score here on the landscape management scoreboard. Handoff, Gervonta Thompson breaks two tackles this time. Splits around the right-hand side. No holding call on LaFleur downfield. And another lead change as Sam Houston scores on the 20. First yard touchdown. So we are going back and forth and back and forth. The third score here of the third quarter.
Well, this was a high scoring game last year, Richard. Ooh. I think 41-28 last year.
Here's a snap. Kick by Cormier. The up and good. Well, here we go again, 5:28 to play third quarter. Lead change now in favor of the Broncos, 35-28 on the landscape.
Southwest Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values. If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota and Tarver Ford. Hi, we're the
Big Daddies. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddies opens at 6 a.m. and serves homestyle breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome to Big Daddy.
Football on KLOC TV. Our game of the week tonight, Sam Houston Broncos and the St. Louis Catholic Saints. Broncos score again, lead 35-28. And another big touchdown run by Trevante Thompson.
Unofficially 27 yards.
Here's another squib kick beside to the left-hand side or the right-hand side of the kick return team for the Saints. And again, good field position. The Saints just had problems keeping a handle on the ball their last drive. 5:27 to play in our third quarter. Saints scored first. Sam Houston eventually took a 14-6 lead. We were tied at 14. St. Louis took a 21-14 lead with 7 seconds left in the half. Sam scored to make it 21-21. Now we're back to Sam with the lead, now 35-28. Pitch left, Rodriguez looking for a hold. Nice block.
Oh, great job.
And a great job to break a tackle as well. Is making contact, but he didn't wrap up. Rodriguez took advantage of it and got another good 4 yards. Originally, yeah, it was going to only be about a 2-yard game.
Yeah, good job by Rodriguez to bounce off and make the spin move and keep driving forward. The kid does a great job of keeping his feet moving. You know, he had over 1,200 yards last year, and he missed a couple games with injuries.
So, second down. A lot of options for Charlie Cryer and the Saints. Bono, two men to his right this time. Pitch right side. They'll come with a fake with the end around this time, but unfortunately, they don't fake out the Broncos as they kind of fake that end around back to Salier that worked so well their last series, but this time it was a Rodriguez keeper, and he actually lost 2 yards on the play.
Once again, I'm not sure about that spot. It looked like he was well past the 50.
Yeah, third down, a very long three here. This is where the Saints kind of struggled in the last drive. Play clock down to 10. Old tighter aces formation with man to the right and left and eye back formation behind Fontenot. Long count, handoff. Rodriguez sprints to the right. He's got some room. Oh, he can't break a tackle and may have lost the football.
Got a flag down, too.
Nope, didn't lose the football.
Yeah, white hat's indicating Sam Houston ball.
He went down very quickly at around the 44-yard line.
There was a flag. And they're going to pick
gonna
it up.
They're going to wave off the flag.
Once again, turnover hurts Saints.
Ouch.
Not only a good field position, but a chance if you don't make the first down to pin them back. Instead, we're going to give them the ball right around midfield.
Second turnover this half, Cannon. Tell you what, Sam is not showing that they're going to not make you pay when those kind of things happen.
That was the first half. It was the Saints capitalizing off Sam Houston turnovers and mistakes.
Boast behind center. Now the handoff to Ottawa. Ottawa goes to the right-hand side across the 30, the 45, the 40, the 35-yard line, first down. And they are trying to strike quickly and attack the Saints while the momentum iron is hot. They finally mark it down. Where'd they mark him down at? Got inside the 35 to the 32-yard line. Almost kind of in the backfield, but almost doesn't count. Dropped at the 30-yard line as a player almost intercepted the handoff. At 52?
Yeah, it's 52. That's Peyton Huval. He's a junior.
Okay. I mean, he was right there.
Yeah, I mean, he almost took the handoff.
He almost took the handoff, and unfortunately it was Thompson who got it at the 30, second down and 8. Play comes in, ball on the right hash mark. Game brought to you today, our game sponsor, Stein Home Improvement, everything you need for your home and garden. On second and 8, roll out, bootleg left. Getting chases, Levi, can't catch it, but DeBose, somebody finally trips him up over the 20-yard line.
Yeah, DeBose faked it and rolled out to the left, and there was nobody out there.
Naked bootleg there, and another first down for Sam Houston. Now inside the red line, the red zone, I mean. On first and 10 at the 19. 3:04 on the game clock. DeBose under center. Pitches right. That's Thompson. Thompson at the 15, 10, 5.
Score.
Touchdown. Didn't even get touched.
Not that time.
From 19 yards out, Thompson leads now with four touchdowns, over 200 yards rushing, and the Broncos take the 41-28 lead.
And, Richard, we didn't want to see the Saints go down by two scores.
No, that's what you didn't want. Again, just with the ball control.
Hey, update from Shreveport. Bird has scored again. It's now 46-7, Bird over the Bar Bucks.
Oof. Snap back in the dirt, but unfortunately, Saints can't get there, but it was missed wide left. First one, Cormier has missed tonight. But it's been the Trevante Thompson show. Four touchdowns. The last one hurt really bad. With only 2:47 to play in the third quarter on the Landscape Management scoreboard, it's Sam Houston, 41. St. Louis Catholic, 28. You're watching.
Good driver? We've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Berner. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Cormier the kick, 41-28 your score. Richard Dow and Ken Nordigo here is Sam Houston. That's five Sam Houston taking on the 3A Saints, and this has been a very seesaw back and forth game. Here's a squib kick again that gets away from the Saints front line, but I think it was finally jumped on by a Saint over there on the far side. And St. Louis Catholic, who has struggled with two turnovers their last two possessions, cannot afford to do that anymore. Penalty flag is on the ground. Nope, that's not a penalty flag. That was a Saints flag. The ball boy who keeps the balls dry dropped his flag that just happened to be yellow on the ground. 43-yard line where the Saints will start this drive under center Fontenot. Hands it off to Salier. A little misdirection attempt there, but Salier is only going to pick up, if any. Oh, he's actually going to lose a yard. Again, a little questionable on the spot, but nonetheless.
I haven't noticed the Sam Houston spots, but the St. Louis spots certainly haven't been very favorable.
Salier's hurt. Not hurt, but he dinged up a little bit. I don't want to say hurt, but he obviously is not feeling a whole lot of comfort right now.
Trainer heads out about him, Coach Croft.
Again, he's a freshman. The opportunity to play a big ball, and they may hit harder than they do over OLCS or St. Margaret's.
I'm not sure where he came from, but he didn't face anybody like the size of Sam Houston.
Absolutely.
In junior
not.
High, I guarantee you that.
He's going to be okay.
And he may not face anybody this size the rest of the year.
And depth not being under the ball. Hope you
5A school
dropped in the pocket for a sack at the four.
Right in the middle. Every time drop back. One thing is either a shotgun or a little pistol formation, which a lot of last year out of the Saints.
Timeout called by the Saints.
Saints will use their second timeout. I'll have one left.
1:36. Let's go ahead and take our final break here of the third quarter on the Landscape Management scoreboard. Sam Houston, the Broncos, leading the Saints 41.
Bill Bailey's, where we're right on the corner and right on the price. Tired of pushy salesmen and being turned down by dealerships because of your past credit? Today is your lucky day. At Bill Bailey's, your job is your credit. With credit acceptance and your down payment, we could get you in a qualified vehicle today. Credit acceptance will help reestablish your credit, provide you with a quality used car, and put you on the road with credit recovery. So come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise Boulevard and get pre-approved today. Bill Bailey's, where we're right on the corner and right on the price. Tired of
By Mack, who not only was playing defensive back there for a second, but almost made the reception.
Well, Mack is the starting free safety. He turned into a defenseman there, and that would have been a costly interception.
Yeah, especially here in Saints territory. Last two Saints drives have ended in a turnover. This one will have Mack back to punt. Low snap, but gets the punt off pretty well. Not the best of the night, but gets the job done. In fact, takes a Saint roll inside the 25 to about the 22-yard line. Well, key possession, I would guess, for St. Louis Catholic Saint defense here.
Yeah, we're going to have to get the stop. You know, other than Thompson breaking a tackle and making long runs, we've done a good job of stopping him. Yeah.
1:15, 1:60.
Well, in fact, if you remember, what turned this game around was the Saints had him stopped, and the miscue on the punt, and the kid ends up running it for a touchdown for Sam Houston. And
that was a huge momentum.
It's been all Sam Houston ever since. Yeah, Saints definitely had the momentum going at that time.
DeBost is under center. Turn around, hand off Thompson. Thompson gets hit at the line and hit in the line and hit at the line and finally brought down.
Somehow ends up staying on his feet.
Have you noticed, Ken, a little change in the offensive mindset for Sam Houston? DeBost was in the shotgun for most of the first half. Almost under center, more deceptive, I think, he is under center than necessarily in the shotgun.
Yeah, and they've gone strictly to the run game, where in the first half they kept trying to throw the ball, and we saw that last year. They go to the run game with Thompson and wear the defense down.
Was a pickup of a yard for DeBost and the Broncos. Man in motion, he'll get it to Ardoin. Swinging to his right and smacked hard. Contrera in there, as well
and
Johnston.
Johnston cleaning up, and Perkle coming over the top.
Perkle, yep.
Looks like Perkle's got a little cramp.
Yeah.
He'll be all right.
That's what I'm worried about. First game of the year.
First game of the year. It's humid. The defense has been on the field a long time. It's a wonder we haven't seen more cramping.
That should be the last play here of the third quarter. The Sam Houston Broncos on the Landscape Management scoreboard lead 41-28. Fourth and final quarter to come in this first game of the
20. Good driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Berger. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
See it anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves home-style breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Salesmen being turned down by dealerships because of your past credit? Today is your lucky day. At Bill Bailey's, your job is your credit. With credit acceptance and your down payment, we could get you in a qualified vehicle today. Credit acceptance will help reestablish your credit, provide you with a quality used car, and put you on the road with credit recovery. So come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise Boulevard and get pre-approved today. Bill Bailey's, where we're right on the corner and right on the price.
Four, three, two, one, five. fourth quarter action. 41-28 your score. Richard Dow can order to go here at Sam Houston High School, where the Broncos with the football on this third down and sixth play and a penalty flag. Somebody moved up front. And I should move them back a little further. That doesn't mean anything. If you turned away and then he came back, you're wondering what happened with that third quarter.
Yeah.
I mean, the Saints were up 28-21, had all the momentum, and a fake punt touchdown went about 61 yards for Sam Houston. A turnover by the Saints.
And I'm not sure it was a fake. They lined up short.
Yeah.
He looked like he was going to do the rugby style.
Yep.
And just it kind of broke down, and he took off. And a missed tackle or two, and all of a sudden it's all Sam Houston.
I think it was his job just to read the coverage.
Third and 10.
There's the boast. Pitch right side. Oh, there's Thompson.
And
he's
stop.
Absolutely blasted out of bounds. But the Saints player is not getting up. That was a pop.
Well, I still don't have his number.
That
was Angie. That was 44.
44, Angie.
That was a big stop. Now it's fourth and six, and
yep.
Sam Houston's going to have to punt.
All right. Saints did what they had to. That was a huge stop for the Saints.
You notice Michael Mack returns punts. You know, the way Salye returned.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I would venture to guess that Mack has the better hands back there, and that's why you put him back there on punts.
Well, he's your senior. He's this is not his first ball game.
No. In fact, Mack has played in quite a few ball games over the years.
That is a position that you earn the coach's trust. There's a high punt.
And
Mack doesn't call a fair catch. If a senior to teach the freshman thing is like, hey, I'm up here. Wave at me. But then, not a.
One thing I saw back here, several times on extra points, and we had quite a few last year. Cookhouse, very close to blocking a punt tonight.
For the Saints.
We'll see some block kicks this year, Richard. Those two guys blocked quite a few last year.
Fourth quarter action. Fontenot under center.
And there's a flag.
Somebody moved. 11:15 to play on the Landscape Management scoreboard. Again, your game day sponsor today is Stein Home Improvement. Once again, a proud sponsor this season. St. Louis Catholic Saint football, Stein Home Improvement, everything for your home and yard. My yard needs cutting. Ken got his done today.
Well, most of it.
Most of it?
Yeah.
Okay. A
couple low spots. So.
Jerry says his is a little high. Mine is high. I did mine last Tuesday. Danny Eccles has a cow. He needs to go to Stein. Two men to the right-hand side. Now Salye comes over, and again, I think we may have got past the clock. Yep, clock's at zero.
So first and 15 is going to become first and 20.
Well, I think the freshman was not in the right spot. They had moved him from one side to the other.
Yeah, they were trying to get trips right with Salye.
Yep.
All in all, that kid's had a great night and hopefully has a bright future with Saints football.
41-28, Sam Houston. Saints, unfortunately, had good field position but are now going backwards on first down and 20. Pass is picked off.
Nope,
incomplete. That was Woodson Hayes that had a chance to intercept that.
I think it was intended for Washington.
Yep.
And he got hit. Woodson Hayes and never saw the ball coming. If Kramer could have turned around, he easily made the grab. Of course, he wouldn't have gained anything on it.
Woodson Hayes didn't see it either, obviously.
No, they were tied up. He was blocking.
He kind of looked up. I think he was almost surprised. So the clock stops with 11:10. Receivers both sides. Fotno rolls to his left. Has some room across the 35, the 40. Tripped up at the 42. Very close to the original spot, but it's going to be a couple yards shy. I give him a yard shy. Third down, 11.
Got a player down for Sam Houston, and it looks like a cramp. First cramp of the night.
And again, we talked about Mack going both ways. We'll see Perkle a couple of times, seeing some action on both sides. And we'll see what they try to do on the far side. We will have the water break since this is September. The turf, if you take a look at the turf, it is getting chopped up. And you said you had a chance to see a little bit of eyeball level there at halftime.
Yeah, it looks much worse from ground level than it does from up here.
To their credit, as dry as we had it in July and parts there of August, I'm surprised anything grew green for a while. And this field was immaculate when we started, but we did have a little bit of rain. And unfortunately, this field, they did change the surface here, I think, 3 years ago, where they came in, it had a lot more clay in it. And it used to get really, really slimy and bad when it would rain. And just would not make the rest of the year. Sam tried to kick the ball back a little bit, and the side official was marking his spot in the right area. Player is off the field, and it'll be third down and 11 still. Trips to the right-hand side, including Rodriguez, the back. Empty backfield for Fontenot. In the shotgun, getting chased out, rolling out in the pocket. Had a man open, couldn't find him. And will be thrown down and potentially a face mask situation at the 38-yard line.
Well, the Saints might have got a break there, Richard.
He did have Salier open. Salier was kind of open on the seam, and Fontenot was running for his life. So that'll put it up a handful more yards, and he's doing unintentionally. He'll back to about the 43-yard line. That'll be third down and 10.
So it was the unintentional face mask.
Yeah, the unintentional face mask.
Inadvertent.
The guy
now Sam Houston has to take a timeout. They had the punt returner out on the field.
Situation. So, timeout called. You know what? Let's go ahead and take quarters. Saints trying to get a drive going to get back.
Louisiana has been our home for all of our 30 years, and we're proud to have been born and raised in this community. We're also proud to continue the family tradition of serving the area with honesty, integrity, and Southern hospitality. And between our two stores, we have 150 employees who share those same values.
If you already buy or service your vehicles with us, we'd like to say thank you. And if not, whether you're in the market for an import or a domestic, or you're interested in a career as part of our team, we'd like to invite you to come see what a car buying experience is supposed to be like at Lake Charles Toyota
and Tarver Ford.
Hi, we're the Tarvers.
Good driver, we've got a discount for that.
Yeah, let's go.
Finally, the third down and 10 play. The 10:26 to play in the fourth quarter. Fontenot looks downfield, has Kramer, but it's picked off instead.
Yeah, he just overthrew Kramer.
Interception for the Saints. That's the third turnover of the half, the fourth on the game. And turnovers have really plagued the Saints here in the second half after what was really a pretty good first half. That's Dawson Windsor with the interception for Sam Houston.
Yeah, it was third and 10. He had Kramer to the inside. He just overthrew Kramer. And That equates to a punt.
Today's replay sponsor, Big Daddy's Sports Bar and Grill, your local sports grill with the best burger in town. Well, DeBose back under center. Yeah, I guarantee you they'll take some time off that clock. Man in motion goes right side. Pitch to Thompson. Thompson will get hit and brought down. I did see Cotrera. I was Johnston, wasn't
hit
yep,
him first.
Johnston,
yeah.
Cotrera over there.
We've called those two guys' name a lot tonight.
I told Mark I'd talk about him in the broadcast. We'll talk about him all year, I'm sure. We were looking up at the clock, Ken. It took about 8 minutes to play a minute and 15 when the clock was here tonight. It's been, unfortunately, the scoring will do that to you. 41-28 after what was a limited first quarter.
And that first game of the year, you're going to have the penalties and the turnovers, and we saw coaching mistakes sending the receiving team on the field on third down. I mean,
calling timeout because you don't have the right personnel. Handoff. Oh, there's Levi.
He's going to lose a couple on that. It's going to make it third and about 12.
He tried to squirt out of Levi's arms, didn't he? He tried to get
out
of there.
He jumped up and took off running. Like, maybe the official didn't see that.
Maybe he didn't see Levi laying on top of the back of him there. I don't know.
He was so quick.
Third down. That was for a loss of a couple. And it'll be third down and 12. And I'll tell you what, Saints not out of it. They do have to do something with the football here in the next couple of drives.
Yeah, down two scores.
Down 41-28. Thompson taking his time. Play clock down to 5. Barks out the signal. That's Thompson going left side. There's Johnston and Crew wrapping him up.
Looked like Brookhouse hit him first, and then Alec Reddick had a shot at him.
And Andrew over there as well.
Then the whole crew caught up to him. That'll bring up 4th and about 9, so the Saints will get the ball back here.
Mac back.
Barring any unforeseen.
punter touchdowns.
Yeah.
They're taking the time. Are they going to?
Yeah.
Here comes the punt team down the 15 on the play clock. And
that's a different punter.
That's a different punter, yep. Different formation on the punt, too.
Oh, that's John Woodson Hayes.
And Hayes almost getting a hand on it.
I'm telling you, it's going to happen pretty soon.
That punt back, this time Mac doesn't touch it. It'll land at the 38-yard line. Mac acted like he was going to catch it. 7:39, so able to take 2.5 minutes off the time, which is unfortunately the 12th man right now for Sam Houston. Is the play clock. Sam leading 41-28 on the landscape management scoreboard. I'd like to thank Tarver Ford. Give us a chance to earn your businesses today. And Lake Charles Toyota, where they know you by name. Proud sponsors. St. Louis Catholic Saint football here on KLOC TV. Richard Dow and Ken Ortego here. The ball at the 37-yard line. Fontenot somehow finds Rodriguez. All game long, Ken, that interior defensive line has really had a pretty good push.
Yeah, they've had their way with the Saints offensive line.
There have been times we've been amazed that Fontenot has been able to hand the ball off to Rodriguez. Splitting this time, Washington to the left. You kind of figure Washington needs to get involved here late in the ball game. Back is Fontenot, rolling out to his left, but it's hard to throw to Fontenot when you got purple shirts chasing you. And he is...
Yeah, I'm just looking at the offensive linemen, a couple juniors and a sophomore. I think that's mostly where we lost offensive players last year.
And some of those are also being affected by injury. I know Coach Cryer told me before the game there's a couple of those. Chris Cooley today has just blown up that front line. And I'll have to look at his stats in a bit, but he is a big formidable force down there, number 95 when you see him next time. Lining up
Yeah, they've had trouble with those two guys on the corners all night.
Pitch, left side, Salier. Back to Kramer on the end around, but it won't go far. In fact, it looks like it'll lose a handful of yards.
Yeah. We've tried that a couple times, changing directions, and Sam Houston's done a great job of staying home, especially early in the year like this.
Water break time, 6 minutes on Landscape Management scoreboard, 41-28. Sam Houston leading St. Louis.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
Big Daddy's opens at 6 a.m. and serves homestyle breakfast until 10 a.m. A daily plate lunch is offered, along with a full lunch and dinner menu, including the famous Big Daddy's hamburger. Big Daddy's also has po' boys, salads, seafood, steaks, frozen drinks, and much more. So stop in today at Big Daddy's Sports Grill, 1737 West Sale Road, in the Athletes Corner Plaza.
Welcome to Big Daddy's. Have a seat anywhere.
See State Farm agent James Berger. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm.
Back to Sam Houston, where it'll be fourth down and forever for the Saints. Unofficially, they have it, I think, fourth down and 25. And Mack back to punt. High pooch punt, and it'll land at about the 48-yard line and then bounce over the 50 to the other 48-yard line, and that's where Sam Houston, with just 5:44 on the Landscape Management scoreboard, a 13-point lead. You need a turnover, you need a stop, and then you need to turn around and find a way to work your offense. And unfortunately, other than the first couple of minutes of the first half, and that was actually electrified by a long kickoff return
as
well.
Yeah, the offensive line have had trouble all night, especially the guys on the corners getting into the backfield.
Swapping it up to Boast under center, where he has been here in the second half. And we'll fake the handoff. Oh, wow. I tell you what, coming through again defensively today, and they're playing assignment football. You can tell, because that's the second time
that
we've had a player almost be, if they've gone for DeBoast.
Peyton Duvall again.
Yeah, Duvall.
It's like he almost took the handoff.
And they call, like,
I'm fine.
I'm okay.
You know, the ball was touched down at the 48. Look where they spotted, at the 49.
That's a full yard, yes.
Yeah. We've seen that quite a few times.
No
tonight.
Less than a half a yard. Interesting. Well, it's back where it started.
Clock running.
Second down, and the clock is not the Saints fan right now.
DeBoast is in no hurry to get up to the line.
Like a student heading to class after lunch hour. He's just not going to get there very fast, is he? There's the snaps rolling out right side. Got some
good
pressure.
Job.
Nice job. Contreras got
it down.
A hand on it. Yep. That will stop the clock in the Saints' favor. Now with 5:03 to play and third down. That's interesting. They have give Eggleston credit for being deceptive, I guess, but they have really thrown on strange times today.
Yeah. You got a 200-plus yard running back, and in the first half when the game was tight, they kept trying to throw the ball.
And now when you're trying to kill the clock.
And then you're trying to kill it, give it to the guy.
Hey, they're ahead 41-28. Here's a handoff right side. That is LaFleur. LaFleur gets out of the grasp of Johnston.
He's going to be short of the first down, though.
Perkle finally wraps him up around the 40.
Well, let's see the spot.
Well, see the spot. Yeah. You're right. He hit him at the 45, and he got another 2 to 3 yards after that. I think they're going to put him down right inside the 43 of the Saints. Nope, they're not. I'm looking at the...
No,
I'm looking at the marker over here, and they put it back now at the 44. The ball marker guy, I think, is the guy that's trying to give him the advantage a little bit. I'd be honest with you, because he was.
He was a little further up.
He was a lot further up.
So they're going to let the clock run down. And I don't know if they're going to take the timeout or the penalty. 2-1. And they're going to take the time out.
Tired of pushy salesmen and being turned down by dealerships because of your past credit? Today is your lucky day. At Bill Bailey's, your job is your credit. With credit acceptance and your down payment, we could get you in a qualified vehicle today. Credit acceptance will help reestablish your credit, provide you with a quality used car, and put you on the road with credit recovery. So come to Bill Bailey's at 2212 Enterprise Boulevard and get pre-approved today. Bill Bailey's, where we're right on the corner and right on the price. Tired of pushy. Good driver, we've got a discount for that and a lot more. See State Farm agent James Berger. He can help you save money by bundling your auto, home, and life insurance. Call James Burnham today in Moss Bluff. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Fourth quarter action here at Sam Houston High School. The Broncos of Sam Houston leading the St. Louis Catholic Saints. Game one of 2015, 41-28 our score. Richard Dow can order go here with 4-12 on the scoreboard.
Broncos are going to go for it here on fourth down.
On fourth down.
Nobody in the backfield.
Johnston. Pass across.
That's what the Saints needed.
Back.
Clock stop. Up.
Really, in that case, the clock was going to stop anyway if he had run the football for a little bit anyway.
Either on the change of possession or the first down. You're right.
Yep. So, and kind of figuring the Saints would probably come up with a tie formation trying to find a way to stop Trevante Thompson, who's had a nice, impressive start to 2015 with four touchdowns.
About 250 yards.
So the Saints really need to score, and they need to score, I would guess, in the next couple, 3 minutes. Here is Fontenot. Fontenot rolls out, and almost caught by Mack, although I think he was more shielded by the defender, who probably thinks he should have had it too. In and out, Mack has played both ways. Mack's going to need an ice bath. Mark Johnson's going to need an ice bath. Mack has just been a trooper tonight with a touchdown catch in the end zone. Some big key defensive plays, even when it, you know, who says hustle doesn't matter when it comes to Trevante Thompson running downfield? I guess hustle matters a lot. Broken bone play here. Misdirection finds Rodriguez on the other side. He'll break a couple of tackles.
Over
the 50, and he got popped on the far sideline.
That was Jonah Baker stepped up to make the tackle, and Rodriguez just laid him on his back.
And a Saint first down. So the clock will stop at 3:52 to play fourth quarter. Saints down 13.
You know, you talk about ice baths. You'll never see any kids play harder than Johnston, Mack, and Perkle. Those kids, they give 100% every time. You can see that. And they're the three dirtiest kids on the field, too.
They have the off-white jerseys tonight. I see the Saints went white on white tonight. Back to throw, hit as he throws. Fontenot's pass is incomplete, almost intercepted again. Sam's got to be wondering how many shots we're going to give these guys. Clock stops at 3:46.
Donovan Johnson, the senior, he's listed as a running back.
The pass in and out of the hands of Johnson. Had no time to got rid of that just to get rid of it so
kinda,
that somebody could make a play.
Kind of floated it out there. And
Washington will split out to the right-hand side. The pass pressure has kept Washington kind of out of this game tonight.
Oh, fumble. Looked like Fontenot fell right back on it.
That'll Set up third down and long behind the chains. Third down and 12. Third down, 12. The final 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Regardless of how this turns out, St. Louis Catholic will strap it back up and get ready to take on Wayne.
Home opener next Friday.
Yep. Cougar Stadium. Heard they've done some more renovations over there. Back to throw. Little screen pass. Washington tried to run before he caught it. And it's incomplete at the 47-48-yard line.
Yeah, they've tried to run that several times. They ran it earlier, and it just didn't go anywhere. And they've gone back to it a couple times since.
Well, the only problem with that is if you're not biting on it, and discipline-wise, Sam Houston has been very good at staying at home.
Saints are going to go for it here on fourth down. Nothing to lose at this point.
You need to. With 3:02 to play. If they don't get it, really, regardless if they do get it, if Sam gets the back, we'll see a whole lot of Trevante Thompson, you would guess. Deep in the pocket.
No time at all.
He tried to step up and thought he had an angle. But there again, the big defensive interior able to stop him. They came kind of with a twist blitz on that. And the inside guy caught up with Fontenot. Who, Fontenot's going to need a nice bath as well. He's just had no time to do anything today. And give him credit. Sam Houston has come with a lot of defensive pressure. They are big. And they have some speed this year, obviously. Sam will come out in the tighter formation this time. DeBost, is it still DeBost? It is. Hand off to Thompson. Why not? Thompson reels off 7-8 yards. Gets brought down. Clock will continue to run 2:45. And it looks as though that the Sam Houston Broncos, with their eye on District 3-5A crown. Talked about Barb kind of getting popped a little bit tonight at Bird. Always have Acadiana, who really is not supposed to be as strong as Acadiana teams in the past. Karen Curl. Also in that district. Sulphur. Sulphur, I think, is going to be improved this year, although they were losing to a pretty good St. Thomas More team. Here's Thompson trying to add to his yardage. Maybe got a couple before pushback to get past the chains. That's the biggest thing. Nice sportsmanship by Cotrera, who made the pop on Thompson to help him up. The sportsmanship came after the pop, but that's okay. That's what football is all about, baby.
Yeah, final from Shreveport. Bird 53, Barb 14. South Cameron 55, North Central 6.
Things are changing at South Cameron, folks.
Marksville.
Interesting season. Washington Marion, I know they've been struck by some injuries. I actually saw Freddie Harrison at a St. Louis volleyball game here a week back just before the Jamboree, and been hit with a few injuries on the internal line, but he's expecting some bigger things from Washington Marion this year, returning a lot of guys.
In our district, South Beauregard came back to beat DeRidder 26-20.
I'll be darned.
Westlake falls to Leesville 41-24.
You know, I really thought South Bow was kind of like Salmon, losing some seniors and might be a little down, but they appear to be at full strength to come back and beating a team like DeRidder. I'll be honest with you. I'm glad we don't have to play DeRidder every year anymore, because they usually have some talent over there.
Hamilton Christian, 33. Lake Arthur, 15. Now, Hamilton was close to shutting down the football program. Couldn't get more than 18 kids out a couple seasons ago.
Coach Sensley has a couple guys playing at McNeese now. They actually may see some time at the LSU game as freshmen. Coach Viator going to be having a lot of freshmen in his lineup this year for McNeese.
Fourth quarter score, Centerville in their first year of football leads Grand Lake in their second year of football 13-12 late in the fourth.
All right. I know they're expecting big things at Grand Lake.
Yeah, after Hurricane Rita, Grand Lake got a lot of the kids that were formerly at South Cameron. A lot of the families moved up to Grand Lake, so that school's growing leaps and bounds.
95 seconds left in this one. DeBose just takes it himself. It was a third down and about four over the line. And that'll be a first down. That should just basically about count this one down. I got a little closer look at one of those supposedly yellow towels. They're very orange. They just look more yellow on the field there. I see a lot of promise for this St. Louis Catholic Saints team. We knew he was going to be a rough go early with the strength of schedule. And you know what? That's never an excuse when it comes to football. Charlie Cryer's been around a long time, 19 years plus of coaching. You know, he showed last year he's able to get the most out of his players. This
Absolutely.
Should be a illegal procedure call. And I, you know what? You see the things that didn't work tonight? You fix on those things and get ready to go take on Wayne next week.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be a tough pre-district schedule. You got a huge Sam Houston team here with one of the best running backs in Southwest Louisiana. DeBose didn't look too bad at quarterback. Of course, we didn't see him throw a whole lot. You know, a lot of little passes off to the corner. We didn't see him throw the ball down the field, which in district,
they're going to have to do.
They're going to have to do that in district for the Broncos. But you know, you got a lot of experience coming back. We saw some good things. The defense didn't play bad.
I've never broadcast a rain game. Is that the Frogs?
No.
I know they have the Frog Festival.
They have the Frog Festival. You'd think they were the Frogs.
It's actually the is it the Tigers? No. I don't know.
It slips my mind. And, you know, and the other one is the gate on – it should be the gate on Ducks.
Yes.
You know? I mean, why not be the gate on Ducks? I can't figure that out.
Final minute of this one.
They could get those crazy uniforms that Oregon wears. And
could have all kinds of fun with it. This should be the last play of the game. DeBost under center, play clock down to 3-2, and the kneel. And by the time they reset this thing, the two teams will have shaken hands. Charlie Cryer's got the headsets off. Vaughn Eggleston has won now three times in a row against the St. Louis Catholic Saints. And the Saints get ready to take on Wayne next week. Ken, pleasure to be back in the booth with you here this year. And we'll be back at it next week.
Huh? Good to have you back, Richard. Yeah, we'll be back next week. Ironically, the final score, 41-28, was the same as last year.
Absolutely. Big thanks to our sponsor, Stein, our game sponsor today, as well as Lake Charles Toyota and Tarver Ford. Our final score on the Landscape Management Scoreboard. Sam Houston goes 1-0 with a 41-28 win over St. Louis Catholic here tonight. For Ken Ortego, Richard Dow, also for Danny Eccles and the boys, you've been watching the KLOC game of the week.